Well, good morning, everybody. We're out on a really wet and damp and cold November morning. But we're not going to let that put us off. Because guess where we're going? We're going to the woods. And we're going to cook up a fry up this morning. A fry up with a difference. A fryer hash. I'm really looking forward to that. So come and join me in the woods. Let's go and cook some breakfast. Well, the rain that we've been having over the past few days certainly made a difference to the actual surface of the ground along the path here. You can probably hear it. But onwards and upwards, let's get into the woods. And set up a camp. With the leaves being wet, you don't get that crunch as you're walking through the forest. I know sometimes I call this a woodland, sometimes I call it a forest, and I weren't really sure what the difference was. So I googled it, and a forest is more designed for the days when game was being bred and kept for hunting, and those particular woodlands where the game were running free awaiting to be hunted was known as a forest. But to me, I'll just use whichever word I want to use at the time. I just love being here. can hear muntjacs. They're quite deep into the woods. But that's where I'm going, deep into the woods, so you never know, we may come across some. So we're just passing Alfie's camp there. Quite a long way into the woods now. I'm not sure how far I am in without looking at my phone to have a look at my whereabouts, but I know this wood's enough now to know that deep in there, and the ground surface has changed quite a bit as well. It's now starting to be sort of lumpy and clumpy, so I've just got to mind where I'm walking as well. But it's all good. I love exploring. And you can see how the ground surface changes. So from this clumpiness, going into a flat, leaf-covered area, it's strange how that changes. But this is the sort of place that I like. I like to settle down. So let's just find a spot and set up camp. Getting warm now. Okay. Let's set up camp. We're using the DD tarp again. This is currently my favourite tarp. And the camouflage is really good too. Right, that's the tarp set up. Well, I've had to be really careful where, how I set my camp up today. So I'm actually not far away from the walkway over that way and the walkway across there. So I need to be really quiet. So I've set up a bit of a firewall to hide any flames from that direction. And the trees are a little bit thicker in this direction, so I'm not too worried. So, first things first, let's get the fire on. I've had to dig out a couple of clumps along here and just flatten it out a bit. It was all a little bit bumpy with the moss. But I seem to have flattened it enough to put the stove down. So, talking about stoves. Got a different one to show you. This one you've probably seen many times on YouTube, with people trying it out. I quite like the idea of it. I quite like the principle of it. What I don't like is all the blue stuff that's on it. But I've took what I can off, and I should just burn the rest off, I think. Right, so let's just stand the stove there. Okay, now then. The grill goes in the side. There, like so. That's it, that goes in. Now hopefully, I'm not going to get too much drop out of that. And it has got this little door on the front. Again, I've took the blue film off of it. But there is still some left on the inside, because it is blooming, it's hard to get off. But I'm sure it's going to burn off. And then of course you've got the top plate, and you've got these two handles at the side. So you can lift those up and you rest your grill in place. I think we should give it a go. I know it's stainless steel. It is going to warp and it is going to bend when it gets hot. But I've been using a very similar one for quite a long time now, from Ohuhu. And that's still working fine. I've got some water on the go now.
make a nice cup of tea. The wood is also wet. Okay, let's start prepping our breakfast. I've got a bit bigger board today. Makes life a lot easier. So, as I said earlier on when I was coming in, I was going to be making a fried breakfast hash. So the first thing I'm going to do is prepare some potatoes. I'm going to keep the skins on them. Nothing wrong with keeping the skins on, I'm sure. Just cut them into cubes. Probably only need one potato actually. Now we'll do them both. I think I'm going to get them on the go in the frying pan straight away, because they're going to take a little bit longer, I think. Let's put a bit of oil in the pan. A little bit more oil in, I think. That's it. Next, I think I'm going to do the onion, I think, next. Just gonna chop it. Let's throw the onion in as well. I'll sprinkle that around. Okay, put all the rubbish to one side, which we will pick up later on. Right, next I think we're going to put in, what should we put in next? Put some garlic in. Okay. Okay, whilst that's cooking, we need a bit of a meat element in there, don't we? So let's got some sausages here. Okay, next we're going to cut up some mushrooms. Just take the stalks off, throw them straight in. No messing about, just get them in there. Okay. So I'm just going to cut these into quarters. Okay, let's get them in the pan as well. Give it all a good stir up. Got a couple of hash browns as well, which I was going to just put on the side of the plate with them, but I think I'm going to slice those up as well. They are still frozen, so that's the good thing about a hash. The hash is put anything you like in it. Okay, now we're going to get a tomato. Cut that down into small pieces. Let's get that all in there as well. There is a lot in here. It's looking really good. It's looking very tasty. Okay, I've got some sea salt. Let's get some sea salt in there. And some black pepper. Like it nice and peppery.
lovely.
Is that all a bit of a stirring? I've just dropped a couple of egg yolks in there as well. There you go. It's probably a lot more there than I anticipated, but I'm sure I'll eat it all up. So I'm just going to put a bit more pepper on the top of that. A little drop more salt, just a little bit. That's it. Then go and find somewhere nice to sit down and eat my breakfast. All right, let's give this a go. I hope I'm gonna be able to eat all this anyway. I was a little bit worried about the potatoes. I weren't sure if I'd left them, cook them long enough. And they're all right. They could have been a bit softer. The potatoes have soaked up the garlic. I can taste the garlic in the potatoes. I'm going to try and eat all this up, all of it. So, let's just remind ourselves what we've got in here. Two potatoes, cubed. Four sausages, chopped into pieces. That sort of size. Four small cloves of garlic, an onion, two eggs, and five chestnut mushrooms, and two hash browns. What? I'm a grown boy. I think I need a nice cup of tea again now. Maybe a lay down. Waiting for the kettle to boil. Get a nice cup of tea. Whilst that's cooling, I'll just go for a little wander just to see how close. Just to see how close I actually am to the walkways. Somebody just walking across there. They've got a bright red jacket on, so they stand out like a sore thumb, really. Well, at least that shows me how close I am to the walkway. You'd have to look really hard to see me through the trees, though, I think.
this camp. So it does seem quite camouflaged. I didn't go all the way to the walk, to the pathway, but I went towards it. All in all, it's been a nice spot. Had it been a sunny, hot day, I probably wouldn't have stayed here because there would have been more people around. More people around in the woods, probably, or in the pathways around the woods.
Never know I've been here.
Right. Start walking towards the path. I'm not going to have so far to walk today, because as you know, I was relatively close to it. So, the only thing is now, don't know exactly where on the path I'm going to come out. But all paths lead to somewhere. I'm just going to stand still for a moment because there's some people walking by with a dog. if I just stand still, I won't attract their attention. The dog's seen me. The dog's seen me. Oh, it's all right. Luckily, he's going back to his owners. They've stood still for a minute. That's it, they're carrying on walking now. Now I would have hid behind a tree, but there's not actually a tree directly in front of me. They're to the sides and I didn't want to make any sudden movements. Okay, they've moved on now, but they are going to be going across this way now. So whilst they're behind that thicket of trees, I'll make my way. And this is the problem with building a camp close to the pathways. I think I'll go this way. God, it's actually quite warm. Sun's come out. How different from first thing this morning. Got to cross this ditch now. Whoop. The branch I hung on to broke. Never mind, I've got to cross. Okay. So, we're on the path now. Let's make our way. Make our way back to the van. Beautiful countryside. So what I think I did this morning was I was going deep into the woods, and I went that deep that I became closer to the walkways at the other side, because the walkway we're on right now is round the opposite side of the woods to where I would normally come out. It's not a problem because it'll all lead to a centre, leads to the centre of the woods, and then I'll just pick the path that I want to go on. Now I know I say it every week, but I just love this place. And if we just get the rest of the autumn out the way and then get through the winter, I'll have spent time in this woods throughout all the seasons. And that's the aim. I started coming here in the spring. I remember the first time I came here, I was amazed by the bluebells that were all over the place. and I'm looking forward to seeing that again in 2023.